My name is Massimo Bandecchi. I'm currently special advisor for system and concurrent engineering at ESA ESTEC. And I started as one of the founding fathers of the CDF more than 20 years ago. A space mission and or a spacecraft are very complex machines, very complex system. So we need a number of experts in different disciplines to design their part of spacecraft. Traditionally, the specialists working in a space mission, they tend to work in their environment, so in their office or in their lab. In a complex system, every part depends on other parts and how they are designed. For instance, the power subsystem is designed only when you know how much power the other subsystem will use and consume. You understand that you cannot design a system if you don't have the information from your colleagues. So if you work sequentially and if you are isolated one from the other, then you miss the communication, and there is the big risk that they diverge in what they do and they don't create the ideal optimal system. They create a bunch of subsystems, a bunch of parts which not necessarily, like in a puzzle, they can fit together effectively. So the time that took to design a mission in a traditional sequential way was 4 times higher than what it takes now using this room and using the concurrent approach. We define beforehand which disciplines we need. We gather them all in this room, and we keep in this room the specialist for not more than 4 hours, because it's a very intensive work. They have to do their design of their part, but they also have to communicate what they do to the rest of the team. And they have to verify that what they have proposed works at system level. So all this process has to be coordinated by someone who is conducting this process. It's very much like an orchestra, and you need a conductor of the orchestra who knows what the music to be played has to be, and directs the various specialists to play the music in sync with each other. Of course, now and then he might call in front one of the specialists to explain their discipline, which is similar to playing a solo. So the rest of the orchestra keeps on playing the music in sync with the solist that in that moment is in front of the team to explain the design of the subsystem. We have done more than 300 missions, so now you challenge me to see which one is the best. But let's say one that we have done recently that is quite unique and strange is for long-duration interplanetary missions. You know that at the moment, if we want to send a spacecraft to Mars, it takes 6 months. So if we think of human missions of such a long duration, we thought to study the possibility to hibernate the crew or to put them in a torpor, you know, dormant status for most of the crews to reach Mars, for instance. Why that? Because in this way we would need less resources, we would need less food, less oxygen. We wanted to understand if this would have an impact on the spacecraft that we need to go to Mars, transporting our crew. Well, amazingly enough, it resulted that this would be better from a psychological point of view. And certainly we would have a benefit in the system, because we would reduce the mass of the spacecraft and finally also the cost of the spacecraft. Of course, on the other side, we will have to have proper control system on board, the proper hibernation facilities, which today do not exist. So we are talking about several years from now if something like this will be realized. Another one, let's say, more scientific, that I like very much also because it's one of the first that I have conducted many years ago, is the Solar Orbiter. And I like it because, as you probably know, last June the spacecraft reached its closest point to the Sun, being able to take images of the Sun and the poles of the Sun. The distance was still amazing, was 77 million kilometers, but still was half of the distance between the Earth and the Sun. So we went halfway what we normally can observe from Earth. Now I'm particularly happy about this result because originally the mission was studied in the CDF, so we have studied missions that maybe will be realized in 30 years from now, or missions that can be launched in 2 or 3 years from the moment in which we do the study.